This is Sunny reading Shay and the Leprechaun. Sunny, go ahead.
The brass Santa Shay's face is once walker. She jumped out of the bed and rushed to her window. Outside, the birds were chirping. Not a cloud was in the sky. She was so happy. It was St. Patrick's Day. She had something very important to do. She ran downstairs. She called to her mom and dad. Happy St. Patrick's Day. Today I'm going to catch a leprechaun. Lula called her mother, but she was already out the door. Jinx, her dog, followed she outside. They ran into the grassy field near her farmhouse. The field seemed to be painted with bright flowers. Spring was in the air. This is a perfect place to find a leprechaun, she told Jinx. And when we find him, we'll make him give us his bag of gold. Jinx barked at it to say, oh boy. Then she heard a strange laughing noise. It seemed to be coming from behind the big oak tree. The tree stood in the middle of the field. She told Jinx, keep quiet, don't make a sound. They sneaked ever so quietly toward the big oak. The laughter got louder and louder. She peeked around the tree trunk. She couldn't believe it. Right before her very eyes was a tiny man. He was dressed all in green. He was dancing and singing a happy song. Come along, my dear lassie, oh come along quick. This wee Irish man is playing his old trick. Come along, my dear lassie, oh come find me go. Before the day passes and I grow another years old. She jumped from behind the tree. She grabbed the little leprechaun by his neck. Then she shouted, give me your gold. So you got me, little lass. The leprechaun replied, just let go of me jacket stick. Then I will tell you where to find me bag of gold. Without thinking, she did as she was told. To her surprise, and the leprechaun did not run away. Instead, the wee man said, "Got to the big rock in the center of the buttercup patch. Look all around. Tis there you shall find a bag of gold." She rushed to the buttercup patch as fast as she could. Jinx followed at Shay's heels. He searched everywhere for the leprechaun's bag of gold. All she found was petals, and more petals. She hurried back to where she had found the leprechaun. Of course, he had disappeared.
All that was left behind
was a small four-leaf clover. She picked up the four-leaf clover steadily. She looked back toward the buttercup patch. There was that cheeky leprechaun dancing a jig on a big rock. He was holding his bag of gold and laughing merrily. Happy St. Patrick's Day, better luck next year, the cuddly leprechaun shouted. And with that, he was gone. All the way home, she told about Last Clever Leprechaun. She thought about how she had let him get away. She told about his bet of gold. Next year, I won't let go of that leprechaun. She told Jigs, I'll make him give me his bet of gold. Jigs answered with a happy bark. Come on, Jigs, said she, smiling. Wait till Mom and Dad hear his story.
That is the end. Good job.